Understand something, people. Lying will ruin your life. Lying will ruin your goddamn life. Lying ruined my marriage. True shit, sweetie. Lying ruined my goddamn marriage. That's a lie. I cheated. Let's talk about it, though. Let's figure it out. Don't judge me. Let me explain. Yes, people, I cheated. Am I ashamed of it? No. No, I'm not. Do I wish that I could take it back? No. No, I don't. Let me tell you why. You can't evolve as a man if you never make a mistake. The only way that you can be perfect is to fuck up. I get it. I fucked up. Don't cheat. Nah, whatever. Now, do I think cheating was the problem? No, I don't. Cheating was not the problem. Lying about cheating was the problem. If I had been honest about it, might have worked it out. But I wasn't. I lied. And I didn't just lie on myself. I put my best friend in my lie. Now, I don't think that's a bad thing to do. Let me explain why. If you're my best friend, I shouldn't have to ask you to lie for me. I shouldn't have to ask for your permission for me to put you in my lie. You know why? Because you're my best fucking friend, bitch. That's your job. The day that we sign up and say that we best friends, that means that my bullshit is your bullshit. And your bullshit is my bullshit. If you're my real best friend, you should know that I need you to lie for me by the look on my face. If I'm looking at you and I'm not blinking, if I'm like this, that's a goddamn sign. That means the bitch got to drop on us. My back is against the wall. This is not a test. It's the real deal. Help me. Help me. Nigga. Help me. My friend Harry ignored all signs, okay? Let me tell you how shit hit the fan. I come in the house, right? I come in the house, it's like 4 a.m. I'm drunk, people. Drunk as shit. I have no balance. I'm all over the place. I'm rocking back and forth. As soon as I walk in the house, she wakes up. She goes off. You know what? I'm sick of this. I know you was probably out with some bitch. You was probably messing with some bitch. Now I'm drunk. I don't want to respond because I don't have any balance. I'm rocking back and forth. You don't look believable when you're rocking back and forth. So I had to choose a stance in which I look believable. So I chose this. I said, let me tell you something. Listen to me. Wasn't nobody with no bitch, okay? You're wrong. Matter of fact, to prove you wrong, I'm gonna call Harry. Harry not expecting me to call right now, so Harry don't have no reason to lie. And I'm gonna put it on speakerphone, about to make you feel stupid. Watch this. Watch how fucking stupid you feel. Watch. Watch this. Harry. Harry. Real quick, don't lie. Let's stop right there. Let's just stop right there for a second. What does that mean? What does that mean, people? Lie. It means lie right now. I mean, the bitch got to drop on us. My back is against the wall. This is not a test. It's the real deal. Help me. Help me. Nigga. Help me. Harry ignored all signs. I'm telling you exactly what Harry said. I said, Harry, real quick, don't lie. Where are we coming from right now? He said, man, you was with that bitch with the fat ass.
What? Oh, no. No, 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 no. Oh, no. No, 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 no.
Yo.
I was so fucking scared. I was so scared. I thought this bitch gonna kill me. She gonna fucking kill me.
See, but understand something. I'm not mad at Harry. The reason why I'm not mad at Harry is because Harry has done some dumb shit, but I understand who he is. See, Harry might be the smartest, dumbest friend that I've ever had in my life, okay? Let me tell you the dumbest thing that Harry's ever done. Harry invented a code for us to use to let each other know when we were around our women. Basically, if somebody used a code, it means don't say anything stupid. You might be on speakerphone. Don't say nothing dumb. The phone might be loud enough so my girl can hear whatever it is you're saying. It means don't say anything that could jeopardize our relationship. The code was, man, I'm hungry as shit. That's cold, people. Man, I'm hungry as shit. Here's what pissed me off about the code. Harry invented the fucking code. So there's no reason why Harry should ever mess with the code. Here's how Harry messes it up. I'm in the car with my lady. I'm driving. She in the passenger seat. Harry calls me while I'm in the car. I got the Bluetooth shit in the car. So my phone rings. The whole car rings. Harry's name pops up on the dashboard. I answer. What up, boy? Kev, what's going on? Ain't shit. This I knew the conversation was about to take turn for the worse. This I knew it was about to get filthy. He said, nigga. Harry! Hey, man, I'm hungry as shit. He said, I'm not. I just ate. What? Harry! Woo-hoo! Harry! Woo-hoo! Harry! I said, man, I'm hungry as shit. He said, yo, you should go to Subway, get the footlong for $5. What the fuck? I said, man, I'm hungry as shit. He said, oh, that must mean you ready to eat these white bitches.
What? Oh, no. No, 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 no. No, no, no. I ain't eat no white bitch. I ain't eat no white bitches. I never did. Oh, my God, no. Oh, no.
Yo, have you ever been in trouble with your girl to the point where you're afraid to look at her, but you can feel her staring at the side of your goddamn face? I was so scared, I never looked at her. I just looked straight and started making dumbass noises. I started pointing out shit. Oh, look, a Deirbra. You see it? I just saw a Deirbra. I'm fucking killing y'all, man. Get fired on these bitches again.